Welcome everybody to the show. I'm very excited to be here. A bit rusty, to be honest. I've not done this in a while, and it's always a bit stressful. I'm at home right now. I'm doing it alone. I have some help from Kirsty in the background. So it's always helpful to have someone around you. So I'm looking forward to chatting with you tonight. Please post in the chat. Let us know how you're going. How it's going in a lockdown, what's happening with you. Sam is going to be there. So Sam, one of the Atomic Bear guy, will be there chatting with you, just like share your stuff. And after the show, I'll come in and just answer your questions and also share some stuff with you and listen from you guys. So let's get started. Okay, today in this episode, I'm going to take you through my Everyday Carry IFAK Trauma Kit and hopefully inspire you to build your own. And if not, maybe you already have one. So maybe you'll spend some time to review and improve what you already have in your kit. So if you're watching live, stay tuned until the end of the show for a chance to win one of our products. There will be a little contest. As usual, we always have some goodies. If you're not watching live, make sure you subscribe and hit the little bell. So as I said, you'll be notified next time and you won't miss one ever again. So let's get started. I want to say first off, big disclaimer. I'm not a professional, I'm not paramedic, I'm not a doctor. I'm a professional, but not in the medical field, if you know what I mean. So my advice here should be taken as entertainment only. So you might say, well, Jeff, why should I listen at all to what you have to say tonight? Well, guys, you and I are obviously people who care about safety. And as the founder of the Atomic Bear, I've had the opportunity to build amazing relationship with different professionals in the field. And I've spent many hours learning and also practicing my first aid skills. So I also produce a full first aid class with a friend of mine, Yuri, who is a combat medic. So today I'm just entertaining you with what I've discovered, and I think what I'm sharing with you will be useful. So let's begin. Okay, so I'm a bit on the technical side on my own. So let's shift to the next step, which is what is the difference between a regular first aid and trauma individual first aid kit, IFAK. Well, your usual first aid kit will be there for bumps and scrapes. You have like Band-Aid and stuff like that. A trauma kit or IFAK kit, this version has mainly things that will be there to prevent you from dying from a big injuries, where there's a lot of blood, like you're emerging and you are losing a lot of blood. So things like a big cut or a bullet hole can kill you many ways, but one way is to make you blood a lot and lose it. So to demonstrate what a good kit could look like, I will use my personal IFAK trauma kit and pouch as an example of what yours could look like. And if you have different ideas of what should be in a kit, what a kit should look like, please just comment, tell Sam and tell me what you guys think. We'd love to hear what you think about stuff like that. We always learn from our fans. It's a very beneficial interactions. I love you guys. This presentation will have three main parts. Very easy. I'll start about what I put outside of the pouch. I will talk about the choice of the pouch itself, and I'll show you what I have as a pouch. And I will tell you what I carry inside the pouch. So it will basically cover everything from A to Z of what an IFAK trauma kit can look like. So number one, what to carry outside of the pouch. I keep things that need to be accessed quickly outside. You know, things that like in a rush, an emergency, I'll have to grab without having to mess about opening it and finding the thing inside, quick access. So let's switch camera here and I'll show you the pouch. This is the pouch I'm carrying mostly in my car. You see here outside, there's a lot of stuff around it, right? It helps me to feel that I can access to important stuff. One of the important stuff here is the The tourniquet. So if you guys don't know what a tourniquet is, it's basically a tool that you can wrap around one of your limb if you're bleeding and losing a lot of blood to stop your blood circulating in the limb, which can save your life. That's very important to have it quickly accessible. I also always carry this pair of a pair of scissors or trauma shear that are very handy to cut through clothes without hurting the victim. So you see the round bits there. So I'll put it back here. On the front here, I want to move and talk about things like if it's dark outside, I want to be able to quickly take my flashlight and have a look at what's happening. So it gives me a quick access to a tool that can be used for self-defense. You see the little serration there, and it's pretty powerful, and it has a strobe mode. This is one of a flashlight. This is the SWAT flashlight. And basically it's small, it's light, it's powerful, it's convenient. So I like to carry this one in this kit. And I also carry a tactical pen. Well, this tactical pen is one of our four tactical pens. This is the MTP6. What I like about this is that there's some redundancy in terms of flashlight. There's a light here, and you see you can just use it if for whatever reason this one is not working. There's also a glass breaker if I need to get inside a car to get to someone, where I need to escape a car in a car accident. This is easy to access in the front here. There's another cool thing about this little pen there is I can unscrew this, and I want to show you what I do. So I'm going to go back to looking at me here. So if I open it like that, and I can just put it in there, and I have a light right on my hat, so my hands are free and I can look at what I'm doing. This is a double use of the pen that I like. If I move into looking at this little, I the sign from Kirstie, she said, you have to come back to your other camera, and there we go. I'm talking about this little guy here. This is from 5.11 Tactical. This is a great little Velcro attachment that, you know, you can take with you, and you can put your flashlight in there. There's some space to put your cards. It's pretty convenient. I like this one. So just attach it. If you have a piece of Velcro on your jacket, you can put it in your jacket. You can switch it, and it's to another bag. It's pretty convenient. This little patch here, it's in a medical patch. It's very important because when you describe to someone, oh, go get my medical kit, there's sometimes no way to know what is a kit. So this little patch, what is a medical kit? This patch will avoid lengthy descriptions. And also will make the thing obvious. I carry my knife also on the outside. The reason is this is the SWAT knife that we make. What I like about this knife and why I think this should be part of my kit is mainly because of the serration here of the blade. The serration can let you cut through a seatbelt quickly, or clothes, or rope. It's pretty convenient. The size is good. Also, there's a 3-inch blade. So whatever I need to cut, or if I need to use it for defense, hopefully I'll never have to do that ever in my whole life. But if I have to, this is there. So this is a convenient tool to have on the outside of the pouch. And finally, the keys. Keys are always useful. And if I'm carrying this kit on my belt, I can put my keys right there if I want to, or if it's on my bug out bag, I can put keys that are meaningful for my bug out path. And if I need to, I can attach it and put it on my belt or put it somewhere else. This comes with the molle attachment kit. So we have a molle attachment set that has all sort of attachment for molle enabled webbing bag, and that's pretty convenient. You can attach about anything on this on a pouch like that with this type of attachment. So that's more or less it about the inside of the pouch. Now, if I go to the out to the pouch itself, the number two is covering, as you remember, obviously, is covering the pouch itself. So you need to ask yourself where you will keep this kit. Will you put it in your bug out bag? Will you carry it on your belt when you go to the shooting range? What activities are you going to do with the kit? And this will define what type of attachment gear you'll have. Will you have a molle attachment, or is it going to be a simple kit you'll just slip into your bag that you can carry in a bigger bag and put in a pocket where you can have access to it quickly? So depending on your need, you will definitely have different type of IFAK pouch. Now, coming to the this specific pouch that I carry, and not surprisingly, like, I make stuff that I like to carry. This pouch here is a little bit convenient for multiple reasons. You see all the molle webbing in the back on the side here. There's some Velcro on the front where I can attach different patches or different things that could be convenient. And on the side here, I can attach more things to it. The webbing on the back is like molle compatible. So basically it can it allows you to attach this onto a belt, onto any type of bag outside. So it remains easily accessible, quickly accessible, and convenient. It's a little heavy. So one thing I do is, this is my day-to-day belt. This is the Atomic Bear belt. So I actually use everything we make. And this is a very nice belt. It's sturdy. And what is useful here to know is that if you pick a belt, make sure that you have this double stitching. If it's made of nylon, double layered, so it's stiff enough, but not too stiff, so it stays comfortable while you're wearing it. So that's about it for the belt here. And it's about it about the pouch. Look at the size. Depending on what you're going to carry in this, you'll have a bigger and smaller pouch. And you may want to spend some time studying what you actually will want to put into your IFAK pouch before you you make a choice. Last thing, you have what is called rip away or fast open system. So if you just pull this this little handle there, you quickly have access to what's inside the pouch. So this is a nice segue to actually talk about the third aspect of the presentation or the show is what I carry inside my pouch. And there's so many things you could possibly carry, so you have to make choices. And most of the choices that that I make here, because it's for trauma, I want to have anything that can focus on stopping the bleeding, the hemorrhaging, because it's a trauma kit, obviously. So you want your main focus on that. And the rest is more added bonuses if you have more space and it's still convenient to carry. So let's have a look at what I do have inside. So first of all, notice that everything is more or less attached, is not falling apart. So it's pretty much, I open it and it stays still. Also, notice that there's nitrile glove accessible, available right there. So I can take my glove, there's blood, I don't want to be contaminated, put my gloves on to start with. The other aspect is that I have a lot of bandage and dressing. A key dressing is this Israeli bandage that is basically a compressible bandage that helps to control the hemorrhage that without having this tourniquet pressure. It helps to, if you have like wound, you can put your dressing on it and you can wrap it with this, put some tension, especially if it's on a limb, if it's your torso, a place where you cannot apply a tourniquet, you may want to have use something like that that will stop the bleeding or reduce the bleeding if possible. Talking about bleeding, this is something you need. You need a sponge, and they have like they call it hemostatic sponge. Basically, it helps the blood from clotting. You put this bandage or this dressing on the wound, and it reduces and helps the coagulation of the wound. So this is used in combat. They have bigger size. There's different version of it. I like the small size because it fits into my kit, and it's it's nice. So I got this. I want to show you that. You can buy the Adventure Medical Kits. There's a lot of things in there. This came in there. So you save money by buying a kit like this, and it's pretty convenient. You get many items, and it makes it quicker to build your kit. Another aspect here, another trick that I learned from Yuri, and this is one thing that he teaches in his in the online classes in his course. He says, carry this triangular bandage. Why? Because you can use it to support a limb. If you let's say you break your arm, you can make a bandage, attach a bandage to support you. But also, it's very thick. It can absorb a lot of blood. So this is something you want to carry if you need to clean a wound that has quite a bit of blood before you apply something like maybe a chest sealer. So I've got two of these. IFAK Trauma. This is a chest sealer. So basically, if you get a shot in your torso, and sometimes you won't bleed a lot, but what happened is the lung will collapse because the hole in your thorax will prevent your breathing because there's no there's air inside and out, so your breathing is not as efficient. So people can die just with the lung collapsing. So this is two of them, one for the entry and one for the exit. If you're not lucky and you get shot, you can use this, or if any other bad wound in your chest happen, this is very convenient. And you'll see, if you look at this, I'll have a lot more dressing, different size to clean the wound, to absorb the blood, to help the coagulation of the blood. This is another one. This is a gauze that you can use to wrap around and put under more compression, and it's absorbing as well. It helps the coagulation of your wound. Yeah, that's about it. And then you'll see like attachment tape, a little bit of duct tape that came with this pack I showed you that I purchased. This is 3M tape. This is to help attaching your bandage to make them stay still and solid. I want to move on the side here and show you this little blanket. This is an emergency blanket that we sell, but you can find this many places. This is convenient if the person is going under a shock. They might need to be kept warmer. This is easy to carry, and it will help their reduce the loss of heat through convection and conduction and radiation. So it's nice little thing to have. I like to take notes, and I do have a pen. Obviously, this is a Sharpie. Why a Sharpie? For those who don't know, like when you apply a tourniquet, you want to take the time, put the time down, so the medical professional know when it was applied and they can act accordingly. So this is quite important. And I like to take notes, license plate, anything from driver's license. There's something where I need to get information from someone. I have something to write on. I have the tactile pen to write there, and I have this to write onto the tourniquet, or if it has to be a permanent marker. And the rest is like, if you can see here, the rest here is basically antiseptic to clean stuff for small scrapes, and I have more bandage on the side here. So that's more or less about it, about the inside of the kit. I don't know if you guys, you know, have opinions on what I've shown you. You think something is wrong, something is right, something you don't have, you think you would need. Like, just let us know, like comment us, give us your ideas about this. So this is really, really important to think about what you're going to do with each of the thing. And for this, I would have a few more tips to share with you, if you don't mind, that will actually enhance your ability to think about first aid. Tip number one, keep your IFAK Trauma Kit organized so you can find your things easily and open it from time to time. Why? Because this way you can spot if a bandage seal is open, broken, and you lost the... it's not sterile anymore, so you want to make sure that your sterile part stays sterile. And sometimes you might have a missing bandage or missing dressing because it's been used, someone else borrow it, or whatever, it fell off, I don't know what happened. You want to make sure that you know what's in there. And also you might have forgotten how your kit is organized. So opening it once in a while will keep you aware of what's in there, how it's organized, and it will become more spontaneous action when you have to grab something in there under pressure. Tip number two, carrying any medical equipment without understanding how to use it is not that smart. So this is one of the reasons we produce the first aid by a combat medic. Because this class gives a bit of a brushstroke and goes into some deep details about how to apply a tourniquet, depending if it's on the leg, if it's on an arm. If you don't have a proper tourniquet, how can you improvise one? So these type of things are kind of necessary. If you have this chest sealer and you don't know how to use it, like, you'll be under stress, you will do mistakes, you will stress out, you might do more arms than you do good because you don't know how to use this thing. So if you can think of a benefit from an online class, if you think you can benefit from an online class or any information that you can get, make sure you spend some time to get it. Tip number three, A kit like this and some medication to go with can seem a lot of money. But guys, if you're carrying a gun or live in a neighborhood where people are carrying gun or have gun arounds, you can be in danger, and you know that. I just want to play some scenes where we show what Yuri is doing in a class, what he's doing while I'm talking, but. Basically, if you live in an area where there's guns, maybe you feel safe, maybe you don't. But anyway, people spend hundreds of dollars in getting weapons, but don't have the minimum gear and knowledge to survive if they get shot. Well, does it sound smart? Many of us like to think offense. You know, I'm going to protect if someone attacks me. But have you thought about defense? And defense can be even more powerful than offense if applied wisely. So at least think of the two sides. So maybe you don't care about being shot because you live in an area where people are not carrying gun, or you still feel safe. Maybe you're just having a vest that is bulletproof all the time. But think of a car accident, a motorbike accident. Like, as a matter of fact, my dad, when I was very young, lost a leg from a motorbike accident. My friend Mario lost a leg like maybe about 10 years ago from a car accident. He was stopped on the side of the road and got hit by a car. That's very sad, but happened. He got saved by someone, by a police person who applied a tourniquet and saved him by stopping the bleeding. So in both cases, they were not responsible for the accident, for what happened. But, you know, they have managed to survive. So maybe you're working with a chainsaw sometimes, an axe, a knife. Maybe you're mowing your grass. Maybe you know that you're all right, but maybe are your children are? Are your neighbor okay? You never know. You might just be an accident scene, and the only person who can help that person is going to die. So having this knowledge will make you, will prepare you at least to feel confident that you can do something. And you don't wait to be in a situation like that and not be prepared to save the life, because trust me, you might hate yourself for a long time. Anyway, as you can tell, I do care. This is really important. And I say, get your trauma stuff in order and get educated now. I don't care how. Take first aid courses offered around you. Sometimes you can find them at your workplace, at your church, at your gun club. Like, look around. There's maybe not like during the lockdown, it's hard to find areas where people can gather, but actually think about it. There's a lot of information online as well. And if you want to have a look at our class, it's up to you. But anyway, any good reputable source or someone who has like paramedical format training and is a good professional in that field can give you a lot of advice, and I encourage you to look into that. So now I'll go to the goodies. So how can you win something? Well, the common challenge. So basically, after the show, this all the comments in the live section will disappear. And what happened is YouTube will publish this video as a standalone video. And I want you to go to that standalone video and answer this question. When it comes to first aid, what is your biggest challenge? You know, when it comes to first aid, what is your biggest challenge? Sam is there. I'll join you right after this live video, and we can chat about it. I'd love to know what it is. And for those who will answer the questions in the comments in the live video, and I'll tell you how to get it in a second. Actually, it's right here, there, theatomicbearshow.com/show. We have a redirect link directly to the YouTube video. It might take 1 or 2 or 3 minutes for YouTube to upload it and make it live. But basically, if you follow this link below, you will be able to get there. Tomorrow afternoon, 12 p.m. Eastern time, we will draw a winner, and they will receive an Atomic Bear MTP6 pen and the flashlight, both shown in this video today. So, and maybe some other, maybe something else, like Kirsty told me, maybe I should add something to it. But anyway, so the winner will be happy. It's just easy to get there. And also, you know, make sure to check back the Facebook page tomorrow and our Instagram to see who wins. If we can contact you directly, because sometimes, you know, on YouTube, we don't have the email or the information. So if we can contact you directly, we will do. Otherwise, check the Facebook page and we'll announce this winner tomorrow. So also, I want to invite you to the after show party. Just join the party. The chat continues after the live show. Go in the comment section, the video, answer the question the best you can or the best of your knowledge. And then we can just have a cold beer and chat and have fun there. Have a good laugh and can share what's happening in our respective area. As I said, the same thing, theatomicbear.com/show, and you'll be there. So thank you for watching. If you like this show, please subscribe to our channel and hit the bell. It will notify you the next time we post a video or go live. This is Jeff from the Atomic Bear signing off. Until the next time, my friends, be safe and prepare to survive.